That makes sense. Okay, so company pages. So this may be applicable for some of the audience. It may not be applicable for some of the audience. I know that for a fact, because we've had a bunch of questions come in over the past few months from marketers who are using social selling and essentially doing social selling and trying to feed that back into their sales teams and trying to build this feedback loop of content being created that they then reshare on their own company profiles and bring it back and forth to make the company profiles more human, I guess, and add a layer of individual expertise as opposed to the usual corporate, just pretty graphics and no substance behind them. So with that said, Daniel, what's happening with company pages for those individuals who have access to them? What changes are ahead? What have we got to look for? What do we have to look forward to with regards to company pages?
Yeah, so LinkedIn are essentially expanding the options that company pages have. So one of the things they're now adding in are more sort of feature pages. So you'll have your main company page, but then you'll be able to have almost like multiple web pages where you can start to promote products and services in a lot more detail. So essentially, your company page is going to become a micro website. So that's really exciting. It's going to allow you to go a lot more in depth. Whereas at the moment, you go on a company page, you can find out about the company in a bit of text and a link to the website, and then you've got their activity feed. Well, now you're going to have the ability to have multiple pages. And then the other feature, which I think there's been a few ways that this has already been out for a while, but I think they're expanding it again, is the ability for company pages to comment on content. Now, a company page has always been able to reply to comments on its own posts. So if I post something through a company page, I can reply to people's comments as the company page. But now you're able to comment on anyone's post, user, you know, company page as that company. And it's essentially giving companies a voice. And I don't know if you saw this, Will. It was a post that actually I shared, and it went viral on LinkedIn. The whole beans on Weetabix, mm-hmm. You know, where it was this sort of whole feed of all these brands commenting, and it went nuts. And it was so amazing. Well, LinkedIn's now essentially giving their company pages, their corporate brands, the opportunity to have a voice. And people love it. I mean, again, I don't know if you saw the Burger King one for International Women's Day, which was Women Belong in the Kitchen. And they were using it to sort of explain that actually, you know, there are less women in chef roles and things like that. And they're going to try and support that and contribute to that. But again, giving brands a more human voice is becoming a very powerful marketing activity.
For sure. I'm on our company page, salesman.org. And I apparently am a super admin, not just an admin. I'm a super Ooh. Admin. Now, there's a big, massive button in the right-hand corner that says new and admin tools. And interesting, as we talk about sponsorships and paid advertising within LinkedIn, there's a massive button that says, would you like to sponsor an update? So they're going down clearly the Facebook route eventually of a boosted post, sponsored posts within the newsfeed. That'll become as organic reach starts to shrink, they're going to leverage the reducing inorganic reach to push paid content. But it allows me to add admins. And this is important. If you work for a small, medium-sized company, maybe you want to, and you work in sales, and perhaps you are the only salesperson, especially if it's a startup, maybe you want to be an admin on the LinkedIn page of the organization, and you start posting content on there. Even if you're only liking and resharing your own content, that could be a hack to drive, or not even a hack, a strategy to drive more likes and subscribers to your own content. What else do we have? Create a showcase page. I'm going to click this. Okay, so this creates a page name, LinkedIn.com/showcase, and then a URL. And then I assume if I click create page, we're essentially creating some kind of article that you'll be able to see on the main page. Is that correct?
It's a page that's attached to your company page.
Cool. That makes sense. And the other thing I've never even noticed, I've got 100 credits to invite people to follow people in my organization. Should I be using these credits, Daniel?
Personally, Will, I'm not a fan unless you're going to genuinely send them to sort of qualified people. So I get tons of messages from people inviting me to follow their company pages. 99% of them are company pages I'm going to get no value from. And to be fair, just from an honest sort of feedback perspective, I find it quite an aggressive way to ask for something. It's sure. The same principle, Will. Like you can send someone a message through LinkedIn asking for them to give you a recommendation. But if you do it automatically through LinkedIn, it just comes as a really bland message. Daniel would like you to recommend them. And I think that's quite, I don't know, that's not a nice way to ask for something. If you want someone to follow your company page, first of all, create valuable content so people actually want to follow it themselves. But if you're going to ask for someone to follow it, make sure you either have some sort of relationship with them or you do think it's going to be valuable. Again, a lot of people just think by spamming those out, they're going to increase their followers significantly. Those sort of shortcuts don't work.
Okay. And final thing on this before we move on to perhaps some rumors, anything that's hopefully coming in the future. Should salespeople, should marketers, whoever it is, go down the Jay-Z route of things where he's quoted as saying, I am the business. Should they create their own company page, which is essentially a professional page for them? So we see this with keynote speakers, individuals like this, where the company, the individual is the business. Should we have a personal page where we share relevant, timely, useful content? Should we also create a company page for ourselves and post content on there as well? Or are we just diluting the content that we're going to have to put out there by doing that?
Yeah, if you're a salesperson working for a business, I personally wouldn't recommend it. I do have a company page. Again, if you're a speaker, if you are the product, if you're a speaker, trainer, whatever you may be, then absolutely. I mean, I'll be honest, Will. I set this up maybe a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, purely for the fact that having me work for me, if you don't have a company page, it has that bland blank box on your profile, which looks horrible. And I just wanted to have a more corporate logo sort of thing on there. So I set up a company page. Now, I haven't shared, Will, a single bit of content through that page, but I've grown an audience of nearly 900 followers. Zero content shared. I don't know why people are, how they're finding it or following it, but they must go through my profile and find it. So yeah, if you're the product, absolutely. The only thing that would make me lean on that is if you're starting to build a big brand. So your Sarah Braziers, your Tom Bostons, your sales reps, your SDRs, your account executives that are building big brands, then there absolutely could be credibility in them doing that. And if you're a business owner, support them in doing it. It will keep them with you for longer if you support and help them grow it instead of trying to force it to something they do on their own, because they will do it on their own and then they'll go. So I would support them in doing that, but only when you're growing a really big brand like they are.